Hello all you beautiful people and welcome to my video. My name is Alex, aka In the Bat Loop, and this is Chat with the Bat with Theme Park News. I know it's been, for those who have been faithful subscribers for a long time, it's been a long time since I did a video. Just kind of been crazy busy with life and everything, so I'm gonna try my best to be more consistent with my videos. And if you guys are new here, just stumble upon my video, I cover everything theme park. I also take lovely pictures of food. I do food reviews at the park, show you what you can eat. Theme parks are more than just going on the rides. The food is there and it's delicious. Not all of it, but there's a good amount. But yeah, today's just going to be about theme park news. There's kind of a lot going on in the world of theme parks with Universal Studios and Disney World. So I just kind of, you know, want to update you guys on some stuff. Now, the biggest one that came about in the news is How to Train Your Dragon. But before I go into all of that and the world of the first land that they kind of revealed and got into details and showed all the attractions and stores and everything like that, let's look at the merch. Now, they showed us some merch that just showed up at Universal Studios Orlando, and you can find it. It looks like you can find it in the annual pass lounge for right now. I would have to go to the theme park and see if I could find it in the main stores. So for right now, I guess if you're an annual pass holder, you can get a hold of the merchandise. This is what they have right now for Epic Universe for the How to Train Your Dragon. A few shirts. It looks like it's for some kids and one for adults. And of course, for those who did not know, Epic Universe does have their own t-shirts are out, so you can buy that, get ahead of the game. But right now it looks like it's two items, a mug and a flag right now. So but yeah, so this shirt right here says it's $30, shows How to Train Your Dragon, Isle of Berg. It's a nice little shirt. I wouldn't wear it, but for those who like maybe that design, the colors, you know, you can kind of get a head start. $30 for that. This one's for the children. Isle of Berg, I love it. It has all the characters from the movie. And pretty much in the background is that's Isle of Berg. I mean, the land is Isle of Berg. So you're going to see this a massive, very immersive land of How to Train Your Dragon. So that's a cute shirt for a kid. I really like it. That was a good job, Universal, on that. Again, that's $25 for that. And then you get this nice little mug for those who collect mugs, who love theme park mugs, who love How to Train Your Dragon. You want a mug from the movie. There's that for $15. That's priced, I guess, pretty good. And here's the other side of the mug. And like I said, when I go to the theme park, I'll just look for more merch and try to show you. But this is just kind of like the faster way of what of me getting some of this stuff. And then I guess they call it a pennant, but yeah, so $16. I call it a flag. That you can get that for $16 for How to Train Your Dragon. So let me pull up this video so you guys can see how massive and gorgeous this Isle of Berg land, themed land, that's going to open up at Epic Universe. Enjoy.
Yeah.
You guys, that is that not? If that didn't give you goosebumps, I mean, I guess you have to be in love with, not in love, but you gotta be into How to Train Your Dragon. But that looks, as they say, epic. And it looks gorgeous. The design, I mean, just everything, the way they placed everything, it's just, you guys, it's just so beautiful. Like, I don't know, I know the video's kind of quick and they just kind of give you like a couple seconds to see every part of the land and the attractions. But I think the one that I'm looking forward to, I don't know if you guys, you probably have to go back. I mean, I could show you a little bit. If I pull it up, maybe right here, there we go. Now, the one that I'm looking forward to, let's do this so I don't have sound. One of the things I'm looking forward to is this roller coaster. Do you see how this roller coaster looks like it's going kind of throughout the whole park and then it goes into the water? And just right there, you guys can see you're gonna get a splash, a little bit of water. So I don't know how wet you'll get. I mean, it looks like, oh yeah, you're not gonna get soaked, but you're gonna get sprayed pretty good as you're going. I think they said the speed of this is like 40, 45 miles per hour. So you're not gonna get, it's not super fast, but yeah. But yeah, this, I like this roller coaster. I can't wait for it to go, it goes under this bridge into like the fog. And then, you know, you're going like that. Like, this is gonna be a really cool roller coaster, kids roller coaster. It's not gonna be, from the designs that I've seen, doesn't look like it's anything crazy. It's a kid's land, so it's not gonna be going up and down and doing anything insane. It's supposed to be like a kid's coaster. But as you can see too in the tracks, it's going throughout the park and it hovers around a lot of the water throughout the land. So that's gonna be really cool. The other one, I'm not like ecstatic about it, but that one's gonna be interesting to see. I don't know if I'll do it where you'll be up in, you know, in the air and you get to troll and do 360 spins. I do love, let's see if it pulls up right here. There's like a, look at that roller coaster, it just passed. That's gonna be so cool. Just the roller coaster is gonna give you a beautiful view of the whole park, I believe. And it's gonna be so nice. That it looks like is a restaurant that they're gonna have in the middle of the park. Let's see if they can get to it. The one that I'm excited about, let me wait for it. It's like a Viking boat ride where you're gonna have a cannon. As you can see, there's the water, and you're in the water, and these Viking boats look humongous. Like, look at this, they're huge. They're not like your little regular, like little boat rides you see at Disney World. These are like Viking boats that are gonna be in the water, and you're gonna have these cannons, and you're gonna be shooting, like, I don't know if it's like gonna be a point system. I don't know if it's just for fun. I don't know if the targets make any sounds, but I guess you're hitting, you know, different dragons. Who knows what else you're targeting? But as you can see in the video, it looks like it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's gonna be 8 people in a boat standing. There's no sitting down, and you're gonna shoot these water. So I guess depending on the side that you're on, I don't know if you're gonna have the same target on each side, but maybe it's a different target so that you go back on it and then you do the other side, which I hope to do that because it makes it the replayability, I guess that's the right term, to go keep going back on the boat, because you have one side where there's one target and then you realize the other side has some different targets, so you go back on the boat ride and then you target those targets. But yeah, this ride I think is cool. I'm gonna love it. Like, it looks like it's gonna be a lot of fun. And it looks like, as you can see right there in the background, there's water splashing, so I guess you're gonna get wet on that ride too as you're targeting different targets, you know, throughout that little scene right there. So I just, it looks amazing, guys. It looks cool. It has things for kids. It's gonna be a fun themed land. I don't love the films. I like them. I think they're all good movies, but I just have this admiration. I really enjoy dragons. So it's gonna be so cool to see, you know, the dragons. I heard they're gonna use drones to have like dragons flying in the background, and that's gonna be really cool. So we'll see how that plays out. So you have this one of the theme lands getting announced, and it looks like leading up to 2025 they're going to announce each land and go into detail just like this video and show you what you're going to see, what to expect, how it's going to look, the final product when everything's all done and open for 2025. So they choose How to Train Dragon. There's no word yet for the next one. I'm going to say maybe in the summertime, the next one's going to pop up. Because they have 5 themed lands, right? They have the Dark Universe, the Mario, or Super Nintendo, the Isle of Berk, the Harry Potter, and then there's the Interstellar one. It has to do with like space and everything. So I guess there's 5 themed lands, but so there's one. They gotta announce 4 more between now and next summer. So yeah, I would say expect 2 more this year, I would wanna say. Maybe 2 or 3 more this year. And maybe in the beginning of 2025, they'll announce like what the last one and get everyone hyped up going into the summer of 2025. So there's that. Add a Train Your Dragon theme land. If you wanna check out the video, it is on YouTube, or just rewind this this video and watch it again, I guess. So there's that news. Next up on the news, just for those real quick, if you're going to Universal Studios, you want to enjoy Mardi Gras, the Mardi Gras event at Universal Studios will end April 7th. And today is, I mean, we're in April now, so it ends on that Sunday, I believe. Yeah. So depending when you watch this video, April 7th is a Sunday. Sunday is the last day to experience everything Mardi Gras that they have for you. Everything they have for Universal Studios. If you haven't gone to the event, it's a great event. I experienced some good stuff. Let me show you guys like some of the things that I've tried. I can't find it. There we go. Yeah, like here's the different menus. A lot of the food that I've tried is really good. I haven't tried everything, but you can catch more photos on my Instagram, which is down there in the corner. You could check it out. But yeah, this Cuban burger was, or not a Cuban burger. Whatchamacallit? Colombian burger. I don't know why I called it Cuban. Colombian burger. This Colombian burger was really good. And, you know, this from Italy was most things that I've tried has been really good. So there's the Philippines, there's everything. So check it out on my Instagram. I did take some pictures. There is a video. I do have a video out for those who are interested. I don't know if I have it right here. Yeah, like here's my video of yeah, so see, there's a video, it's on my channel, YouTube, check it out. I show everything. I tried beignets, like here's a little preview, there's that, like, oh, it's so good, you guys definitely need to try this. So yeah, go check it out on my YouTube channel. That's just one of the things I do need. I'm gonna go back before it ends and do a couple more things. Even if you don't go to the event, you can kind of see last minute things that I pick up and try at the Mardi Gras festival. Also, some other news. Let's go over here. The Communicore Hall and Plaza has an opening date now at Epcot. Let's see if I can get it to show this. So this is what's gonna look like. Okay, there we go. This is what it's gonna look like when it's all done. There is an opening date for it. Looks like it's gonna be June 10th right here. June 10th, it's gonna open up. It will be home for a lot of the Epcot festivals and celebrations. So all the festivals like Flower and Garden, some of the booths will end up being in there. It's going to be a new permanent Mickey and Friends meet and greet location will be inside there. Right now, you know, you can still meet Mickey and Minnie, but once June 10th hits, that's where you're going to be going. And I read something else. Oh yeah, this is going to be interesting right here. It says, when the plaza opens on June 10th, a new Encanto show will debut. So I don't know what that entails. I don't know what it has, what's all about. I love the movie Encanto. A lot of people enjoyed the movie. I love the music. So it says an Encanto show will debut on June 10th in this pavilion. So that's going to be exciting. Of course, you already know I'm going to be there ready with my camera to film things and show you what it's going to look like, how it looks for everything when it's open. So there's that news right there for you guys. And last but not least, that I don't have it right here, but you guys, it is April, and that is the time when Halloween Horror Night rumors, whispers, things start to come about, come to light. And Universal Studios actually did something interesting where they, let me see if I can find it, because I want you guys to see this. Let me see if I can find it. But they're kind of giving you like a hint. They put up some mannequins which look like the creature, not look like, it's creature from the Black Lagoon, and he's dressed up in different outfits, and they have like, you know, the number for the Halloween Horror Nights for this year, what it's celebrating. And it's interesting that they're dressed up. Let's see. It's interesting that they're dressed up. I want to see if I can find the photo of it. Well, here's something interesting for you guys. Let's look at this. It says, as I was looking for the news, it says, according to an internal hiring ad, Halloween Horror Nights 33 will run from August 30th, which is super early because it's usually like the first weekend of September. So August 30th to November 2nd, that is insane. They're probably expecting this Halloween Horror Nights to have to, I guess, have even a bigger crowd than what it was last year. So they're probably adding more days so they can make a little bit more money. It was they had some really good houses last year, so it was very busy, very popular. A lot of people went. But according to an internal hiring ad, Halloween Horror Nights 33 will run from August 30th to November 2nd. It's not confirmed yet. This is like rumored, I guess, is if someone like maybe leaked information. We'll get until they actually confirm it. There's rumors also, I heard about this rumor, suggests that Fast and the Furious will be closed in August and will be closed throughout the whole Halloween Horror Nights event because of there's going to be two, right here says two tents. I don't know if it's two or one tent. They're going to be, there's a tent that they're building over there and they have to have that part closed. Also, for those who are annual pass holders, don't forget that you will have to, you're gonna be required to have, do a reservation to use on your free night. But that's interesting. That just popped up right now. So that was new news to me as I'm bringing you theme park news. But Halloween Horror Nights running from August 30th to November 2nd. We'll see how accurate that is. From, I mean, they're hiring scare actors right now. So that's not even a rumor. That could be accurate. So we'll see when Universal will announce the dates. Of course, I'll update you guys and let you know. You can also follow me on Instagram. That's where I'll drop all the news. But that's interesting. August 30th, you guys. Huh. Anyways, the mannequins, back to my story. The mannequins were Creature from the Black Lagoon. He's the only one that hasn't gotten a house from the classic monsters. For you guys who don't know, classical monsters involved Dracula, Frankenstein, the Wolfman, the Creature from the Black Lagoon, the Phantom of the Opera. So the Phantom of the Opera and some others had their house. Dracula's had his house. Wolfman, Frankenstein, Bride of Frankenstein. So the next one up is the Creature from the Black Lagoon. So we'll see. I'm hoping he gets one because that would be cool. It'd be all swampy and he just, you know, he deserves his own house. I don't know if he'll be solo, but you know, he definitely, sorry, I'm reading about that I'm hiring about performers. It shows August. That is such an early time to do that. Anyways, so that's a rumored house. Let's talk about rumored houses real quick. So rumored houses, there's the Ghostbusters because it's the 40th anniversary for Ghostbusters. The new movie just came out. There was an article about Universal purchasing the Cadillac vehicle. So I'll put my money on the Ghostbusters house is coming this year for Halloween Horror Nights 33. There's a rumored house of A Quiet Place, and Blumhouse will have a rumored house. We'll see how that is. But yeah, so you guys, there's your news for theme park news. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll give you more theme park news as they come about. Again, you'll get more up-to-date stuff on my Instagram. There's my Instagram, there's my TikTok. Follow me all. Twitter, I need to get a little bit more on, but you can follow me on Twitter. I would appreciate it. If you're new here, maybe consider subscribing. I do things like this. I cover theme park food, like I said. I also cover on my podcast movie news, movie reviews that I need to get back on because I've been slacking. But hey, life got a little busy. But I appreciate each and every one of you guys that are still here, still on this long journey and ride of my YouTube life. And I appreciate each and every one of you guys. I hope you have a great day, great week, blessed month, and always be yourself. Unless you could be Batman, then always be Batman. See ya.